I mean, she just became a different person.
In what way?
Well, she changed. All the joy went out of her. She became very tense, and there was a fear in her eyes.
Fear of what?
I don't know. I never asked her, and she never told me. I was afraid that I'd be intruding on something very, very personal.
You know, it's just possible that you're reading more into Becky's behavior than there is. I mean, it's really tough for me to imagine Becky Lee Hunt as a woman with a past. It's even difficult to think of her hiding anything at all.
No, no. She had something terrible hanging over her. You know, I think that she was afraid about her and Richard being together. She was just haunted by it constantly.
I mean, look, is there anything that we can do to help Becky right at this point?
No. I just wish that there was.
Me too. You know, I have a feeling, it's just a feeling, but I have a feeling that wherever Becky is right now, she knows exactly what she's doing. And when she finally does turn up, you'll see, there's a totally logical explanation for everything that's happened.
Oh, dear. I hope you're right.
I will be. And now, I would like to talk.
Well, isn't that what we're doing?
No, I mean about us.
Oh.
It's my favorite subject.
Mine, too. Well, what about us?
Well, I wrote down an agenda. Let me see where I put that. Where is it?
Well, it must be a pretty important stuff.
Oh, well, it is. It's about our life together.
Do you think maybe you could remember any of it?
Oh, well, let me see. The first point. First point is setting a wedding date.
Great. When would you like to?
Let's see. Today is Wednesday.
Oh, Peter, I thought this was serious conversation.
Well, it is. How's Saturday?
This coming Saturday?
Sure, why not?
Well, why the rush?
Well, I mean, what's the point of waiting? I think we should get started with our lives together right away. I don't like bringing you here and kissing you goodnight at Ina's doorstep and then going home alone.
Oh. Well, I could move in with you.
Would you?
Well, I'd rather get married first.
Me too.
Oh, Peter, I'm so glad. I mean, you know, if you had asked me to move in with you, I would have. I love you so much that I'd do anything you wanted. But
you're an old-fashioned girl, huh?
Well, you know, I never thought about it, but I guess I am. Except, I don't think I can be ready by Saturday.
Oh, I can understand that. I mean, that's kind of a rush. How's Sunday? Hey. As soon as possible.
Great.
Yeah, about 5'7", early 20s, short brown hair, kind of a Carolina and twang to her voice. No, huh? Well, all right, thanks a lot for your trouble. If she does show up, you'd let me know, will you? Well, the easiest thing to do is to call the police emergency number, tell them you have a message for Lieutenant Hall. They'll find me, okay? Right, thanks very much.
Well, how many is that, Ed?
Well, there are two or three more hotels, and they're all the motels.
Of course, if you went to a motel, you gotta figure the man was there. How many times do I have to tell you there's no man?
Oh, Richard, you're just exploring all the possibilities, that's all.
Well, that's not one of them.
Yeah, well, from what little I know of Becky, I'm inclined to think you're right.
Yeah, well, thanks.
However, this is a little bit of speculation, and there is no evidence to support it. However, there is no evidence against the possibility either.
Well, the evidence is Becky's character and what I know about Becky.
Right. Fine, okay.
No, there's no point to that.
Well, no, there might be a chance.
No, it's like you said. I mean, if she left at 8 and then 4 hours passed, I mean, she could have gone 200 miles. Now it's 2 o'clock in the morning, she could have gone 300 miles.
mean, that's a lot of territory. She could be anywhere. She could be in Philadelphia, in Pittsburgh, in Washington, D.C., even in New York. That's a big area. I mean, even if we called every motel, I mean, there's no way. Even with the help of the FBI, we just... Look. Forget it.
Well, I'm willing to keep trying, would you?
No.
What's the use? You know, you checked into a hotel, she's probably under an assumed name.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I figured. That's why I keep giving out her description. How many people pay attention to someone who's checking into a motel? Like I said, look, you go home now. Your wife is probably wondering what happened to you. I'll think of something. Okay. All right. Well, let me give you a little something to think about. Try to think of somebody Becky might have confided in. That she might have told she was going to leave. But she might have told she was going to leave beforehand, before she did it, you know? Well, Mrs. Hopkins. You know, I don't know why she left. I mean, we were supposed to leave from New York, go to Paris in 12 hours from now. That's tomorrow at 2 o'clock.
Well, yeah, she got cold feet about something. Hey, listen, she might have changed her mind. She'll be here first thing in the morning, you know?
Yeah, I might never see her again. Is there somebody she might have talked to?
Mrs. Hopkins.
Yeah, Mrs. Hopkins, she's the most likely.
Yeah,
that's
good
thought. Want me to talk to her in the morning?
No, I'll do it. I'll call her first thing in the morning.
Okay. In the meantime, I'll let you know if I hear anything, all right?
Thanks a lot, Ed, huh?
It's all right. Good night.
Good night, and thank you.
My pleasure. Take care.
Thanks again.
Okay.
See you home. I mean, why don't you go home, too? How do you have to work in the morning?
I'd like to stay, Richard, if I may. So I can just curl up in this chair. And suppose the phone rings, or if you can't sleep, you might want to talk. Or if something does develop, well, then I can run errands for you. Please, Richard. Do you have any spare blankets?
Do you remember the preacher saying that? Becky, I'm gonna tell you, I believe in that. And I'm gonna make a believer out of you, too. You wanna hear my plan?
Can I get up?
Certainly you can. If you don't be foolish, act nice, not run off like you did before. There now. That's nice and sensible of you. You know, I think we're going to get on real good from here on in. Don't you?
And you haven't had anything at all, Richard?
No, I thought maybe you had.
No, she'd get in touch with you before she would me.
Oh, I don't know about that, Mrs. Hopkins.
Well, I do. Look, I've tried very hard to be a good friend to Becky. As a matter of fact, I think she thinks of me sort of as a second mother, but... Well, for heaven's sakes, you're the man she loves. You're the one she'd go to in trouble.
Mrs. Hopkins, what do you know that I don't know?
Well, I can't imagine there's anything.
Well, I think there is.
Oh, Richard, I love you. I love you almost as much as I love Becky. Look, this thing is hitting me very hard, you know. I mean, well, I can't tell you how terrible I feel about what's happened. I mean, I can't tell you, Richard. I can't tell you why. I can't tell you where Becky is. I can't tell you anything.
Please, Hopkins.
Listen, Richard, I know one thing only, and that is that Becky loves you more than anything in this whole world. And no matter what's happened, Richard, it's never going to change.
She's got an odd way of showing it.
Oh, listen, if you knew the circumstances, you couldn't say that.
Mrs. Hopkins.
Please, now, just to the... Richard, what I meant was, look, there may be extenuating circumstances that you and I never even dreamed about, right? And don't you know that if there was anything in the world I could do to help you get that girl back, I would in a minute. Oh, Richard, I do love you. You know that. Oh, darling, look, that's probably somebody with news right now.
Miss Hopkins, I gotta go. I gotta cancel reservation.
Oh, good morning, Mrs. Hopkins.
Good morning, Mrs. Lord. Won't you come in?
Thank you. Oh, good morning, Richard. Is there any news?
No, nothing.
I'm so sorry. Listen, I was just talking to Joe Reilly, and he said for you not to worry about catching your flight this afternoon. He'd like you to stay and get everything cleared up before you take on your new job. He'd also like to talk to you as soon as you feel that you have a free moment. He's at the office.
Okay, Dorian, thanks. I'll get down there right now.
Wait a minute. I'm so sorry, darling. I couldn't be more help.
Mrs. Hopkins, I'd like to see my sister.
Oh, well, she's been up and out hours ago.
But it's only 8:30, and where could she have gone?
Well, you see, last week she started her riding lessons. And she says it's much more pleasant to go early in the morning before it gets too hot.
Horseback riding?
Mm-hmm.
But why in the... Where? Where is she?
Well, let's see. It's called the Nine Maple Stables.
Yeah,
I think it's north.
I know where it is. Thank you very much.
And if you would answer this for me, Edwina, general rejection, but let him down easy. You know, tell him we'd like to see more submission.
Of course,
okay?
I know what to say.
Anything about Becky?
Not a thing.
I can't understand it. She just disappeared into thin air.
Excuse me. Mr. Benedict is here.
He says it's important that he see you.
Thanks, Sharlene. Tell him to come right in, will you? Look, Edwina, you take care of the rest of these. You let me know if there are any problems, all right?
Of course.
Ray Benedict was my boss when I was in Washington. I haven't seen him in over a year.
He's bringing you good news.
Thanks. So do I.
What are you doing up here, Ray?
We got ourselves a problem, Paul.
Well, I assume that. when they told me you were here. I mean, what's going on?
We got a lead on Cantrell and Harmer.
Well, that's great.
No, no, it's not great. As of about an hour ago, they were only 60 miles from here.
You're aiming on a stay in here.
Well, now, this hotel room costs too much. Besides, you can't cook for me. Ain't hardly nothing to do with.
But in Landview?
Sure, why not? Becky, you didn't think I was going to drag you back down home, did you?
I didn't know what you were thinking,
Vic. I sure wouldn't deliver you down there, not after what happened.
I thought you wanted to see me punished.
Well, you know, there's all kinds of punishment. Besides, it appears to me like you got a good thing going here. Bullies Club. I took that old boy at Ten's bar down there and some of the other folks, and he kind of appears to me they like you.
They're real nice.
How much they paying you?
Oh, now I see.
How much?
Look, you don't understand. I was going to leave here. I gave up folks my job.
Well, you can get them again. That one, anyway.
I don't know what you're thinking about.
I'm thinking about we got to eat, Becky Lee. At least to decide what we're going to do next.
I won't do it.
Well, we'll see about that. I think maybe you pick up that there phone, call that good old boy down to Blue Ridge Club, tell him your plans have changed. Tell him you're going to be staying on here a while. You kind of like to go back to work for him. And you talk nice and pretty like you generally do. And I...
No!
You're bashful. That's all right. You just give me the number. I'll give him a call.
I'm going to tell you something, Lou. If you think that we're going to set up house here and live together like man and wife...
Well, we are, ain't it?
Won't work.
Why not?
Cause. You can't be with me every minute. And the first chance I get, I'm going to get out of here. I'm going to run away so fast and so far, you're never going to find me again.
Ain't going to have to, honey. The law will do that for me. Let me tell you something. After I called the law, after I told him about you, put him on to you, then I think I'd just look me up old Richard. I wanted to meet him for a long time. Kind of curious to see what kind of a man could change you so much. Sorry. I got a score to settle with him. Might as well do it sooner or later. Your choice, Becky Lee. Either I call the law or you give me the number that they're Blue Ridge Club. What's it gonna be?
All right, the rented car is found approximately there.
Abandoned?
That's right. The engine was cold, so they've been gone for a while.
Are you sure it was Cantrell?
Yes, and Harmer's with them. My people did a quick fingerprint check, which confirmed the handwriting analysis of the rental application.
Why would they abandon the car?
Well, they figured to retrace them, and they were too hot.
In which case, we can assume that they stole another car.
MO. When they're closing in on somebody, then they abandon the stolen car as soon as possible after the job's done.
What do you think they got planned for me?
One of two things. Either kidnapping, hold you as a hostage until they clear the country.
Or assassination.
Yeah. Either way, we gotta move fast. Get you and your wife to a clear house, a safe house up in Canada. Now, I call the military. They're gonna have a plane pick you up at Landview Airport and take you as far as Winnipeg.
What about you? Are you going with us?
No, I'm going to go ahead and clear the way, check out the security. Don't worry, you're going to be protected all the way down the line. You've got everything you need right here, instructions, identifications, how and where to contact your Canadian control.
What about my wife? Is she safe?
She's fine. Okay. I told the security people around your house that she's to stay put until you get home. Now, here, take that. If I'm going to get a hit, sir, you're going to take off right now.
Okay.
Goodbye.
Are you?
John, call the 9 Mason Station. Find out who runs the place. Find out anything you can about it. And then as soon as you have that information, let me know.
Yes, Melinda. Paul wanted me to bring these over to you. It's the revised budget for the next quarter. He thought maybe you'd want to see it before the next meeting.
Are you all right?
My word, you look awful. Well, I didn't get very much sleep last night. Sit down. Sit down, I'll get you a cup of coffee.
Thank you.
Edwina, tell me, is your conscience bothering you just a little bit over Miss Becky?
Dorian, I told you, I don't know where Becky is. I had nothing to do with that.
But you can't be too displeased over what's happening.
No, I'm very upset and very concerned about Richard. In fact, that's where I spent the night.
Oh? Actually, I was curled up in a chair. But Richard was pacing around so much, I don't think either of us slept very much. I won't bore you with this. I'll just have my coffee and go.
Well, there's no hurry. Just relax.
Excuse me.
John, did you get the information on the riding stables yet?
Well, please, keep trying.
You going to take riding lessons?
No, I'm not going to take riding lessons. It's for Melinda, and I have to stop her.
I mean, considering the terrible childhood accident she had, I wouldn't think she'd even want to look at a horse.
Let alone she considers it a challenge.
Oh, for heaven's sakes, I'm so sick and tired of hearing all of these climb every mountain syndromes. She doesn't have to prove anything to herself or to anyone else.
What kind of accident was it?
She fell. She was taking a jump. You see, that was a challenge, another challenge that she thought that she had to make, because I was a better horsewoman. Anyway, her arm was seriously hurt. Partial paralysis. As a matter of fact, for a long time, we thought that her career as a pianist would be over with. She was so traumatized by this whole experience. I mean, all she had to do was see me in a riding outfit, and she'd become so upset. And now she's planning on taking riding lessons.
Maybe she's overcome her fear.
No. Something or someone has convinced her to do it, and I'm going to find out who and why.
Well, now, I am right proud to hear you say that, Mel. Yeah, I always thought Becky had a whole lot of talent. Now, I tried to encourage her every way I could. Yes, sirree. Now, she'll be down there tomorrow night. Don't you worry about a thing. Right. Well, nice talking to you, Mel. Ciao.
I won't do it.
Honey, for the money they're paying you, you could stand on your head for 3 hours tonight. Actually, if we ought to get us one of them nice little apartments down there near the club. You know where that new building's going up? Yeah, I saw Miss Sonny.
I won't stay. I'll leave. First chance I get.
Why, you ashamed of your husband with all your new fancy friends you got up here?
Not a matter of being ashamed.
Well, what is it then?
Do you know why I married you? Because my papa said I had to. Because I was young and I didn't know any better and I didn't have any place else to go. Now I do.
Get on the phone, Becky. Call old Richard up. I think it's time we gave him the word, don't you?
But I can't just get on the phone and call him up.
Don't you worry. I'm going to tell you what to say. And the first thing is goodbye. You tell him you don't ever want to see him again. Then.
Please, Luke, just let me go see him. Let me talk to him. Let me explain it to him.
No, ain't no way you're ever going to see him again, and that's the whole idea. Well, you going to call him? You want me to?
Well, Mr. Slattery, these deeds all seem to be in order.
Well, they are, Mr. Pearson. You'll see there that they're all signed over to Hauser Chemical Corporation. Every last parcel of land that you wanted there.
Yes, I see. Including the acres across the river where we plan to build our industrial park.
Yes, that's all there. Now, all I need from you is a check for $6.5 million, please.
Yes, indeed, Mr. Slattery. I had it drawn after our first conversation today in the hopes that we could reach an agreement.
Thank you very much, Mr. Pearson.
Well, I'm glad we finally got together and did some business.
Yes, I guess so. Price you're giving, you're practically stealing it.
Well, according to the original owners, you're selling it to us for about the same price you paid for it.
Well, if you don't mind, sir, I'd really rather not discuss that.
Certainly, Mr. Slattery. Can I buy you a drink to clinch the deal?
No, thank you. I'm quite a bit of a hurry. I've got to get back to New York right away. Anyway, nice to meet you, Mr. Pearson.
Pleasure, Mr. Slattery.
Maybe I ought to call old Richard up, just so there won't be no misunderstanding.
Oh, wait a minute, Doctor, don't brush you off. I wanted to ask you, how is your new secretary?
Which one?
Oh, now, let me see if I can keep track. Now, first there was Renee, then there was Roseanne. Stop me if I have this in the wrong order. Then it seems to me that the most recent one was Judy McAllister. Oh, you mean the two of you have been together for a whole week? Oh, congratulations. I'm so happy for both of you.
You know, you must think I'm the nastiest, stinkinest old curmudgeon for all time, Mrs. Hall.
And you love it, right? Also, you're so difficult to work for. The personnel send you only the very best people.
Precisely.
So there is madness in your method.
Oh, you have it backward, Mrs. Hall. If I surround myself with efficient people, I naturally increase my own efficiency.
But how is it possible to increase your efficiency when it is already so high? What do you do at night?
What do you mean?
Well, I just wondered if you set the same high standards in your private life. For instance, I wondered if you set perhaps 19 and a half minutes to finish your dinner and an hour and 22 minutes to go through your medical journal. And let you program yourself to fall asleep at the precise sound of freedom at which my head hits the pillow.
Believe it or not, Mrs. Hall, for your information, I leave it all behind me when I go home at night.
Oh, my goodness. You mean you lead a completely unstructured private life?
Well, you know what they say. All work and no play
makes Jack a dove. Oh, doctor, they wrote that for you.
You'd be surprised, Mrs. Hall, just how hard I play when I have a chance to. Not have a chance to very often since I've arrived here. But now that things are a little bit better organized, I find more leisure time for myself. Yeah. Have Dr. Craig call me when he comes in. Now, won't you?
Nothing happened the other night.
So you are going to pretend that?
A lot of talk, that's all.
You mean you don't think that I'd follow through?
You know exactly what I mean. Now, what is this bill for?
Let's see. The 1 is for 100, the 8 is for 80, the 4 is for 486.
Samantha, I mean, what is the bill for?
Logan's housewares department. Breakage of china, glassware, you know, that kind of thing.
That is an awful lot of breakage for 1 month.
Well, you don't have to snarl at me. I don't wait tables. I only help with the books, remember? No, of course you wouldn't remember, because where I'm concerned, you have total amnesia, right?
Samantha, knock it off.
I will knock it off when you answer my question.
I have already answered your question.
Not directly.
All right. I am not impressed by your aggressive behavior. Now, you can call me old-fashioned or whatever you want, but we are not amused.
I didn't realize I was being so aggressive. You told me it was just big talk, so what's the big deal?
You know it's more than talk. I mean, the other night when you were in here with Terry Clark, flirting so outrageously,
You know that that was meant for me.
So you did. You did notice, didn't you? That means that you were very interested.
Sam, I am going to put this to you plainly. I am not going to allow myself to get seduced by you. No matter how sweetly you put it, no matter what kind of rationale you use, you are 18 years old, and that puts you about a mile outside my limit. No. Make it 10 miles outside my limit. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm sure that Henri is about to have a crisis in the kitchen.
Let me talk to him.
Message got through.
Gone. Where did she go?